Hello and welcome. Let me talk about some interesting topics today. The topic of today is Gnosticistic philosophy along with some old Jewish Christian mythology or philosophy, theology, theater maybe. In the old Arabic languages, Baal was the name for the Lord. It is also in some forms of Sanskrit stem. And you can say that the Arabic languages like that are bested forms of Sanskrit, like Italian and Spanish and Portuguese are bested forms of Latin. There are very much similarities, but that is for another topic. But what I want to say is that according to the Gnostics, they are called the gods of the Israelites. Sakless was one of the forms of the demiurges. The demiurges was the creator of the matrix where we live in, according to the most of the Gnostics' teachings, by what I did read about the stuff. The Gnostics did believe that the Lion of Judah, how they call Sakless, which means the fool in old Arabic languages, and there they call also El-Belon, which I hope I pronounced it good, means child of chaos. And that's how the Gnostics did see the Jewish God, as a ruthless tyrant who did not hold himself on his own moral ground and expected others to do the thing that he was not doing. He was against sacrifice. But his most wise disciple, Salomon, did sacrifice 1,000 cattle, later on 20,000 something like cattle, and around 120 sheep he did sacrifice, not because of a need, but because he wanted to offend the Sophia and the Christ, the light and the wisdom, like the Gnostics to call that. Another name that the Gnostics did call the God of the Bible by was Samael, the blind God, the poison of God. And there they believe that basically the God or demiurge of the Bible was just like the, like you can say, the Wizard of Oz. He was not the creator of the universe, not creator of it. He was a deceiver. He did not can create anything. He did only did can corrupt it, changed it. He did not create the atoms of the world. You can say. He just formed it, just like Saruman in the Lord of the Rings. According to the Gnostics, all life did come from the source. The source that it called the monarch, or the monarch, the one. There are some disagreements in suffix. Some did believe that the source was a man. Some did call the source the same as his messenger or her messenger, Barbella. I hope I pronounced it good. If not, tell me in the comments. Barbella was by the Greeks seen often as a form of female divine spirit. But Barbella was also sometimes called stuff like the father mother, which suggests to be a deity that was man and woman, androgynous. So you can argue that Barbella was the source, wisdom or not. The source of all life, the source of the virgin spirits, like the word is being told about in the book of Judah, Judas, the Gospel of Judas, where Jesus did explain about the realm of Barbella, when the so-called traitor of Judas actually did become the one that only did understand that Jesus trapped in the world of the living, the delusion of the demiurge, and that his real place was in the space of Barbella, paradise, the world without suffering, the world without the urge of the demiurge, the urge of desire, because that's what the demiurge means. Demi, the people, urge. Samuel, even if you look in the Bible, he was not a bad one. Samuel was absolute and good guy in comparison with the things the full God Sackless did do. God did kill many people in the Bible for not worshipping them. Created the Ark. The Ark of Noah. Now, people, this God was not nice. According to the Bible, there is a right where attacked by snakes, sent by God. Where the chosen people were killed by the Bible, in the Bible. Why? Because I did start to worship a bull. You know, the same thing that the first king of England did do, the Angles, Sackless. He was the first. Joseph was the first son of his bull. Joseph was called the bull because one of his creations was a bull. The other gods in the Canaanic world that worshipped bulls that come from Egypt, they did have creator and god that this was a bull. And from this Joseph, the people that claim the royal families that claim they were the descendants of Joseph. Because of this, they are on the throne today, because they claim to have a lineage from the bull, Angles,